Hey, welcome back for another episode of ARK Survival Evolved. As you can see, I am right now sitting at our tribe base, the main tribe base here with this big cannons that we got on Pretzel here that we used in our last raid. We did add something new. We haven't gotten to try it out yet on a on a full raid anyways, but the rockets, which is extremely expensive, so we don't have any rockets. Anywho, we got another new thing. I don't know if you notice all these little egg things on, well, these dinos anyways over here, and that one. Apparently they have Mr. Steelio eggs, one of the new dinos that have been added that goes around and collects eggs, which is great, but never stops. I wonder if he's got any eggs. Nope, no eggs. Well, I guess he's going around waiting for everybody to drop eggs, and I don't know. Let's see if we check our eggs chest. Let's see if we got a lot. That's not the door. This is the door. It's really dark in here. Let's see. A lot of Argent eggs. A good amount of Quetzal eggs. That thing is pretty awesome because this is a short amount of time since we've gotten those. I don't know what these eggs were. What I need is some Spino eggs because I need, which I don't think we have any. I need to get me a Megalodon. I need one really bad. Just because I need some kind of sea animal now that I'm built in the next to the ocean. I need me... Oh, I got some of the Spino kibble. Not very much. I need to get food, though. I'm not going to take any of that. I wonder if we have any cooked meat. We have a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and eat these. And I'm going to put this scuba gear back because I was only borrowing it for absolutely nothing. Which will go in here. The other armor's chest. Fantastic. Close that door. So also, we got to check on my Quetzals. They have been doing really good. They're almost completed, I think. I haven't checked on them in about a day or so. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to go fly to my base and check on the Quetzals. Let's see how the twins are doing. Okay, and we're back, and I have a couple of things I want to explain. First, I took a slight detour. I went the opposite way from my base for one reason, but then the second reason I just thought of, I didn't explain something. I actually have some nice things. Early in the week, me and Alk decided we were going to not really raid, so I didn't really record it because it was of a well-known base that the tribe had left. They stopped playing. They don't play on the server no more. So we kind of just went into their base and just decided to blow up a safe, which they had, or one of the vaults, and they had some pretty good stuff. So we got a bunch of really nice things, and one of the things is this Mastercraft metal pick, which is super awesome. It's fantastic, and we found some other nice things as well. Most of the stuff we have back at the main tribe base. But there was no action. We didn't expect any action just because, like I said, the tribe had already left. They don't play anymore. Now, this isn't that base. Now, I came here for the reason to show you. We actually have two new guys that had joined our tribe earlier in the week. So they completely converted. So all of this is now part of the Booty Buccaneers, which is our tribe. They have joined us, and they have a massive metal wall around their base. That's a lot of metal. They also have a lot of Rexes, so they tame a lot of stuff. They're pretty well off, and I think it's going to be really good to have them on our team, so I think it's going to really work. I'm not sure how they feel about raiding and stuff like that, but it'll be something that we find out. Now this right here, this is my Rex. My new Rex, and it's a replacement from Zoom. Zoom is a guy from Legion, I believe. The reason why he gave me this Rex, which looks really awesome with the blue under the white, is because apparently they were actually trying to I guess, defend from what they say my old base where it used to be. I left all the land dinos there, and I didn't really care about any of the other ones except for the Rex. But he was on his Giga, and he saw a Rex fall into my... Did they ban a Pokeball on this Dodo, on this Dodicrous? That is way too cool. That is the funniest thing. So, anyways, they saw Rex go into my base, I guess, or fall off the cliff into the base, and they decided they were going to help out and try to kill it. Well, after they killed it, my dinos decided to attack them, so they were, they had no choice but to kill all the dinos there. So they killed my Rex, Shipwreck, and they gave us this replacement, which we've been kind of just letting it grow up here, because my base really isn't ready for all that right now. And plus, I don't really even know how to get them to the island just yet. I haven't figured all that stuff out. That's something that I'll figure out a little bit later on. But we'll see. So now that I've showed you this, I kind of want to take a tour of the inside of their base. I haven't seen the inside, so I'm not sure how it looks in there, how to even get in there or around all these Rexes. God. All right. So let's go through this door. Oh, so they're storing dinos in here as well. Okay, so they got a lot of stuff and just dinos sitting everywhere. That's a bit strange, but you know what else? Let's see what they have up here. I bet this just leads to outside. No? It actually... Okay, what's going on? There we go. Oh, so they got like a farmhouse inside their base. That's kind of cool, I guess. All right. That's that. So there's not too much going on with the base. I'm going to go ahead and close that door for them. I don't want to just leave it open. No? There we go. So go ahead and walk out, close that door, and find my way back to my bird, which is right here, the Black Pearl. Awesome. So they've got a pretty massive little area covered, and they got their little water pen where they got a plesiosaur. I don't think they have any other ones, but plesiosaur. So that's that, and that's pretty cool. I'm glad we got these guys on our team, so just that much more firepower when we go and decide we want to destroy somebody. So it's gonna work out pretty well. Now I'm gonna fly back to my base just so I can check on my Quetzes. Like I said, I haven't checked them in a while. I know I left them with a ton of meat, so I'm sure they're doing well, but I got a long ways to fly, so I'll see you guys when I get there. Okay, so I have one more detour. I'm going to show you the base that we went into where we blew open the vault so we can just see what was in there of the tribe that left. Yep, it's this one. The really big island that I thought was super cool that kind of knew we were never going to get, but now we're going to get it. As soon as... I know the admins have it like on a timer or whatever. They're kind of keeping track of everybody's base to just... they already know that they left about, you know, a couple weeks ago or so, but I think they said they were still giving them like another week before they come and just kind of wipe the base and clear everything out. But we already went ahead and claimed the island, so this is my stone little hut that I built here to claim this as my land, so nobody else is going to get this, although I don't think anybody else even knows, really. So we... just kind of just ran in here and blew open these doors, and there was the vault right there. So we blew open that. Obviously all this other stuff happened because of that. These are the guys that have been here, and they've just been there for this amount of time. I guess someone else came in and has been killing them, because I think there was like two other guys in here. That guy looks like he's missing a leg. Anywho, so that's what we did, and this island is going to be ours. I know I've been doing a lot of building, but I love building, so I'm glad I'm going to get another chance to build a really big base, and I kind of just want to try out some ideas and stuff on this one now. I don't know if I'm going to work it a little bit differently than what I have now. I only know now that I have the base that I do now because it was pretty much as big as I can get and fit it on this little island. And look at the Quetzes. They almost look like they're full grown. Not yet, though, but getting close. Let's see where they're at. If I can land. There we go. So Grim and Reaper are now a good 70% of the way done. 65%, I don't know, whatever percent you want to pick that's after 50 but before 100. So they're doing really well. Let's see how much meat I got in this feeding trough. 3,000. Perfect. Oh, and if you didn't know, it's the reason I have 3,000 is because there is a mod on the server, which, by the way, I gotta say, is extremely helpful and not too, like, I don't know, it doesn't really feel too cheaty, I guess, but I think the little stack of 20 meats, I think, is a little ridiculously low. I wish they would raise that a little bit higher, at least to, like, 100 or so, but this one allows for up to, like, I don't know if it's 10,000, or I think it might be 10,000 or something like that. But it allows for stacks of that, and you can turn prime meat into regular meat, and it's like one prime meat turns into 50 regular raw meats. So it actually works out pretty well. So that's what we did. I got the 3,000 meat, so it's been lasting a while. It makes it where I don't have to watch them or keep coming back every whatever so often to make sure everything hasn't rotten or been eaten already. Left some stuff on him. Also, I've been using Death Omen and Hank over there, Hank the Ank, to get some metal done, because I'm going to start collecting resources for that next big build I'm going to do. And so far I've came up with this, which isn't a terrible amount, but it's going pretty good. The goal is, by the time that the admins feel like they're going to wipe that base over there, I want to have all three of these chests filled with nothing but metal, or raw metal, and then I'm going to build me one of those forges and go ahead and smelt all that, which is going to work out pretty good. So out of all this, out of nothing but raw metal, it should be about 9,000, I think, is what it came out to. It's like 3,000 ingots worth of raw metal fit in each chest. So hopefully I can get that filled, and that'll be great. Frost is still doing pretty good. So everything's going pretty good. I want to get started on that build already, man. I want that to be a thing. I know one of the hardest things I'm going to have to do is cementing paste. I think, well, not really hardest, but time-consuming. I need another frog, which we have one at main base, so I'll probably use that one. And I'll just have to spend a really long time just gathering nothing but cementing base, because that seems to be the thing that you run out of most. I'm going to go ahead and check my turrets to see if anything has flown by yet. So nothing has flown by here at all. Nobody comes this way. Nobody flies out this direction. So I think I've got a really good base location. I think this is going to be good. I can't wait to be on that island over there. It's going to be great. And then I'm excited for when we're going to do... I like that shadow. It kind of looks like a giant sea creature or something. What is that? What is an icky doing? Ichiosaur? I don't know what they're called. There's something like that. But what is that doing way out here? And why did that just die? Did it just die? It sure did. That is the strangest thing. Probably about the weirdest thing I've seen so far. So awesome, I just gotta check, and oh, another thing we found in the safe, I forgot to show you. One less cave we're gonna have to do, although I don't know which cave it is that has it. So I don't know which cave to avoid, so we're gonna have to go to every cave anyways. But this artifact right here, this one is the artifact of Skylord. Okay. So it looks pretty cool. I think my trophy room is filling out pretty nicely. I can't wait to have them all filled in. I think it's going to look really awesome. Although, by the time I get that, it'll probably be in the new base. But I'm probably going to have the same kind of setup or the same kind of room in the new base regardless, just to have like a good trophy room and have some pretty nice stuff. And I need to put this kibble in the fridge. I really don't want to carry it on me. I'm going to do that. So that's pretty much my plan. And, man, I wanted to show you guys, and I forgot, but back at the new tribe mates base, they were Butters Inc., I think is what it was, before they converted to us. They have a really cool setup with the air conditionings that I really like, and their little hatchery area where they hatch the eggs, and I think I want to do that in the new base. And they have them set up on those catwalks, like metal catwalks or something. And they have them like just, or they're probably not metal, they're wood, but they have them kind of going across the ceiling, and they have the AC systems up there. And I think that's a really cool thing. I think I want to do that in my new base just because I think it's pretty awesome. So I'm going to kind of incorporate their design in helping me build my new base, which I think is going to be pretty cool. Close that door. So there's just a lot of stuff that I got to get done and make sure that these guys get fully grown, which their stats look pretty good. So I can't wait to level them up. And it's going to be pretty... I'm going to have to find some, like... some alphas to go kill, because those give you a lot of levels, which is pretty good. And I think this is awesome because this server actually raised the alpha spawn by like 3 times, I guess, just to make it a little bit more harder. So there's a lot more alphas out there, which is pretty cool. I haven't gotten to see, I think we saw one raptor, and I don't know what they found on them, but you can find some pretty good stuff on the alphas, which is pretty awesome. So I'm going to go ahead and figure out what I'm going to do, because I have no idea what I had planned for today. Probably absolutely nothing, because I didn't really have too much time today. I just kind of wanted to show off some stuff. But I'm going to see what I need to do and go ahead and bring you guys back. Okay, we're back. I decided to craft one of these remote keypads because I have no idea what it does and I want to see what it does. It allows remote access to multiple doors and or lights. So I'm kind of curious on how it works. Do I like put it inside the house or outside the house? Like, what do I do with it? Do I place it? Does it tell me what to do, or... I'm going to go ahead and place it right here. Yeah, let's go ahead and do it right there. So activate, open pins. Let's do that. So, do you not do anything? I don't know what to do. Deactivate clothespins. Okay, so is it when I set a pin to here, set pin code to 9515? So you don't set the other one, I'm just setting doors, I think, right? That's what I'm getting from this. Let's go ahead and try that and see what that does. So if I go into here and click, okay. What does that do? Open. Does this one mean close then? So if I go... Ah! That's so cool. Okay. So awesome. So if I go here to open, all of them open. Alright. I'm going to set all the doors to do that so I can have them all open when I want them and close when I don't want them. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, set pin code to... But I think I'm not going to do it the back ones, because I don't really go out the back ones too much. And before I get all the docking stuff built, I'm going to be have moved over to the new area anyway, so... What else? I wish there was like a... Why does it do automatic open? Like, why can't I do... I have to hold for the close, so everything's closed. Yes, that is so great. I'm glad I built that. That's really cool. I actually really like that. You know what? Actually, that would be really useful over at... I wonder what the range is on this thing. Does this thing have a range? It would be really useful over at the main tribe base with all those ridiculous doors that they have, like the all the different rooms and stuff. You could just sit there, put a pin code in, and open all of them. My guy just pooped on an iceberg. So go ahead and just open all of them and walk through freely, and whenever you leave, just put the pin again and close it. That's super cool. I'm going to do that again just because it's really cool. What? That is way better than having to open up multiple doors all at once. I'm definitely going to keep that for the new base that I build. So it does have to be powered. Is that what I'm getting from this? So yeah, it is. It is taking power. So it does have to be near an electrical box. Go ahead and close this. Fantastic. So I got something accomplished today. Actually, like, you know, I didn't really expect anything accomplished. I just wanted to show you guys some of the stuff. Which, I did get one more new thing. I'm gonna see if this is faster than having to open up both of them. Well, I guess it would be if I had to go, like, all the way back here, but probably be faster just to open up both of those doors. I don't know. I like the pin code thing, though, so I'm gonna keep going. So we found some more advanced bullets. These are all stuff that came from the vault that we broke into and just kind of took stuff from. This is what I was really excited about, the Apprentice Assault Rifle. This is awesome. I'm glad I got a new one, because after that one raid, I lost my rifle and couldn't get it back, and I like the night vision hollow sight, so we found a couple of those. I don't know. I like the green, but really, I kind of want to do the black and blue thing, because I really like this like teal-colored ice blue. I think it's really awesome, which is strange, because I've never really thought much about the color, but like when I see it up against black now, it might be one of my new favorite colors. Like, I think it's really awesome with black. It goes really well. So I kind of want my gun to be that color. Oh, I have no ammo. I was going to try to shoot it. Let's see. I want to kind of show the power of this rifle against a baby penguin, just in case we ever get, like, overrun and taken by baby penguins. Just go ahead and shoot it a couple times at level 32. Kill it. And so this thing does a pretty decent amount of damage to players, which I think is a lot better for whenever we're fighting and you're going to get up close and you start like shooting, because it's pretty easy to miss with the long neck rifle. Even though if you get hit once in the head with the long neck rifle, you're dead anyway. So, or you probably don't even have to get hit in the head. So just go around killing penguins. I'm pretty sure I'm hitting them, but I guess I wasn't. Wasting ammo just because it's fun. I like shooting this thing, plus we got a lot of it, so it's okay. I'm going to put this back though. I don't like carrying it on me just in case I like randomly die. I don't want to lose it, but I do have the backup, and this one is blue and black. That one's just a ramshackle one though. I found the primitive heavy miners. We got a couple of blueprints. We actually got our Mastercraft Pteranodon blueprint, which is pretty awesome. We're thinking about making them and seeing if we can sell them on the server to get stuff, most likely cementing paste, just because it's one of the things that we run out of all the time, and it's such a pain to sit there and try to gather cementing paste all the time. So I think that's what we're going to do, even though it's cost a lot to make. Off of that blueprint, it was like thousands and thousands of hide, which isn't too hard to come by, but when you want to make multiple of them, it kind of is. And it required a massive amount of cementing paste by itself, so we definitely would have to get more than whatever you pay into it. So that'll be that plan. Building over there is my next plan, which I find kind of sucks, because I always find one place, and then like in the middle of my build, I never even get to finish it or fully finish it. I always find a new, better place, and then I want to build there. So hopefully it'll be one of my last moves. I know, just because this island was really just like a I had to take it pretty much, just because I lost the other island that I really, really wanted. I feel like if I was on that other island, even if I found this one, you know, to open up, I probably wouldn't have taken it, just because I like the other island pretty good, and if I was already settled there, I wouldn't want to move. But this island was just kind of like, you know, it was the only thing left, so I kind of had to take it. And I really wanted to live like near the ocean on an island, which is pretty cool. So that's going to be that. I know this episode is probably not as exciting. Not really anything happened except for just showing stuff. I still hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you aren't already subscribed, please subscribe for more raiding videos. We definitely are going to go on some more of those, and, you know, killing people and stealing all their stuff. So that's always fun and exciting. And if you want to get to see those and stay up to date, please subscribe. Like the video, share the video, do what you got to do. And we will see you again for another episode of ARK Survival Evolved.